while curtains have come down on the 2014 FIFA World Cup, controversy still brews in the state of Goa over the Brazilian junket involving the two of three MLAs and one minister of the Parrikar government. These politicians, who returned after watching some of the games in Brazil, have to now pay back the SAG, a whooping 15 lakh rupees each that was spent on them.
Incidentally, after a public outcry, the state government had decided to call off the rupees 89 lakh controversial junket tour to Brazil last month, which would also have seen some of the ministers and MLAs of the ruling government going there to watch the games at the expense of the state exchequer. Following the decision, one cabinet minister, Avartheno Furtado, along with the three MLAs, namely Benjamin Silva, Carlos Almeida and Glenn Ticklo, decided to travel on their own expense to Brazil. Surprisingly, the money for the 10-day tour, amounting to rupees 15 lakh each, which includes stay, travelling, two matches of the quarter-finals and semi-final round, were instantly paid through the Department of Sports Authority of Goa, and the state government had assured to recover the concerned amount from all the four politicians. Although another MLA of the ruling party, Michael Lobo, from Kalangut constituency, was initially a part of the original tour, he later decided not to go to Brazil. Even Sports Minister Ramesh Tavadkar had opted out of the junket tour, facing public criticism that state funds were being blown away on a junket tour. Speaking to Goa 365, Fisheries Minister Avartheno Furtado said that since the tour was planned a month in advance, they had informed the SAG to book their tickets. He also stated that it was decided that once the MLAs are back, they would repay the SAG.
You just can't arrange a trip in 2-3 days. So we were working on this for the last 1 month also, where we had told SAG to book our tickets and to do everything. So they had done all the necessary arrangements. So they had to give money in advance. So whatever, then once we backed out from the government's money, we told them that we are paying our own money. Initially, you all pay the money. But as we are back from the tour, we will surely pay the money. And CM immediately told us, as you all are back from the tour, you all will have to pay the money. He had no problem. We told him yes, and we already received the letter from CM, I mean the sports authority, that we have to pay them the money as soon as we are back.
What is the amount that you are putting
in? It's 15 lakhs.
Each annual?
Yeah.
So by when you are supposed to
pay? By end of this month, we have to pay the full amount, and we will pay the amount.
Furtado stated that all the four MLAs had decided to go on their own expense and expressed the same to the chief minister.
It was given to know that we are going at the exchequer's money. But finally, we only decided like we will not waste the exchequer's money, we will go at our own cost. So we went and told CM we are going at our own cost and nothing to be worried about that we are wasting any government money or anything. So finally, four of us decided to go and we went. I can tell you, the World Cup was really mind-blowing. The performance that was put up by the teams was really superb. We watched two quarterfinals, two semifinals. But I'll tell you, the atmosphere in Brazil was really great. The day Brazil was playing, they started the celebration right from 12 o'clock at night. The streets were full. Young kids were out with the ball. They were so much thrilled that Brazil was playing, that on the day that they were playing, they gave a public holiday. And I can tell you, the stadium was packed and the crowd there was nearly 58,000. And you could see the crowd cheering Brazil in such a way, I tell you, but it was very disappointing that they lost.
Mr. Furtado said that one could learn a lot from the way Brazil organized the World Cup. He said that the state government would soon work on creating infrastructure and to build a stadium of international standards.
See, we learned a lot of things. Once you go there, you can face what it is. And we have seen a lot of things that we can do in Goa. It's not that we can't do, we will do.
Like what?
A lot of things are there. Like, I'll tell you, the crowd there was so well managed by the police. The 58,000 crowd that, you know, you can make out once Brazil lost, what will be their reaction, the crowd reaction. But I'll tell you, it was so well managed that they had no problem at all to get rid of the crowd soon after the match was over. Ground is required. I don't say our Nehru Stadium is bad, but stadium is required. So then, many other infrastructure things, we can sit and talk across with the sports minister and everything. We can do a lot of more development work.
Would all four of you, on your own, would be giving a special report on this issue?
We are going to submit a report.
Right.
Soon we'll sit and we'll submit a report.